Sure, I'll tell him. No worries. Bye. That was Keith. Wants you to cover the evening shift. Michelle hasn't turned up for work.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Isn't Dave in?
It's really busy, apparently.
I hate you so much. You know that, right?
Better get a jog on, mate. You know what he's like.
Yeah, well, next time, tell him to shove it, yeah?
Yes, the stench of death surrounds you. Tread carefully, boy, for today could be your last among the living.
Let go of me, you fucking
dark freak. Shadow over this place.
I've been waiting here for over 10 whole minutes.
Yeah, sorry mate, we're a little bit short-staffed today.
It's totally unacceptable. I want to speak to your manager.
Listen bud, I'm in no mood for this tonight. Do you want your crappy porn flick or not?
Shit. Keep your voice down. Here.
Hey there! Do you want to know a movie fact? You know the mask in Hallow's Eve, the one Mickey Myers wears? Did you know that in that movie, the rockboxer Sylvester Stallion passed out after losing a race to a chicken? Did you happen to know that the cat in The Dogfather was some stray that a producer found hanging around the lot? Did you know that they use real bees when they filmed The Candy Woman 2, Farewell to the Honey? Did you know that Luna Larry, you know, from the story of toys, was originally called Buzz? Did you know that the runtime of Jim Cameroon's The Unsinkable Boat was 2 hours and 40 minutes? That just so happens to be how the boat lasted on a maiden voyage. Did you know that RBO Studios gave all their set props to NASA after they finished filming 3001, A Space Journey? That's all I've got, unfortunately.
What the hell, Toadie? Jesus! Can't a man take a dump in peace? What the hell, man? Were you sleeping in there?
Oh, such needy bastards, the lot of them.
Hi there, my name's Timothy. I'm a journalist for the Evening Standard. I'd like to ask a few questions about the recent disappearances. They all seem to stem from around this location, and I'm interviewing a few of the shop staff around here to see if they've noticed anything fishy.
Sorry, but we know about as much as you do right now.
Understandable. Sorry for the interruption. If you do hear anything interesting, then be sure to give us a call.
Wow, this town has really gone to the shit, man.
You got that right.
November 29th. Interview with Video to Go staff was less than helpful. Something's going on in there, and I'm going to find out what. Better head back to the office. It's getting late. Awful smell!
Clock. Time to close up and get out of here.
I'm gonna head out. You can close alone, right?
What the fuck, man?
Oh, you'll be fine. I'm meeting Michelle tonight. I really need to go and get ready.
Michelle? I thought she wasn't well. She phoned in sick.
She isn't. But she's about to get a whole lot better, if you know what I mean. It's dangerous to go alone. Here, take this.
Yeah, thanks. Unfucking believable.
Tony Byrne, I just wanted to ask you a few questions, if that's all right.
Look, if it's about the TV license, I'm gonna pay it. I just forgot.
I'm sure you will, but that's not why I'm here. As you'll be aware, there have been a spate of missing people in the area recently. We're sort of at a loss at this point, but we did notice that every one of the missing persons had a Video to Go account. I'm just curious if you have your recent customer transaction data to hand. We'd like to check some of the dates compared to their last sighting.
Oh. Yeah, sure. They're in a filing cabinet out back. Just give me a minute.
Perfect. Thank you for your cooperation. This will be extremely helpful. And Mr. Brown, try to remember to pay that TV license.
There. Locked up tight. Now to clean up this shithole. Oh my good God! Jesus Christ, Cap, don't do that!
What's the matter? Let's go. Nah, you'll never survive the war. Hey, did you hear, by the way? Another person's gone missing. That's three this week. What the hell is going on?
That's disgusting. It's been weeks and they haven't even got close to catching this guy yet.
What do you think I feel? At least you get to go home and lock your doors. I'm out here on that. Anyway, I'm just going to have a rest back here if that's alright with you.
All good, man. I need to get back in anyway. I've just got to put the returns back on the shelves and then it's home time. Sorry. No offence.
Not taken. The bins are my home now.
Sorry, we're closed. We're closed. You're gonna need to come back tomorrow. Hey, you're deaf. Fuck off. Christ's sake. Who does something like this? Better let Keith know what happened. Should give him a call. This better not come out of my fucking pay.
Hello?
Keith, it's Tony. Something's happened.
I thought I told you to only call me if it's an emergency.
Well, if you'd listen. Someone smashed the shop window with a cinder block.
What the hell? How'd you let that happen?
Oh, I just rented him the brick and let him have the way. What the fuck do you mean, how did I let it happen?
Alright, I'm coming down. Look, in the meantime, try to find something to board it up. The last thing we need is someone taking our stock.
Well, I'm glad to hear you care about the safety of your staff.
Don't be a smartass. I'll be there soon. Now, board it.
Dickhead. Keith, I thought you were...
We're going to have fun tonight.
Who the fuck is this?
I'll see you soon, you biggie.
Screw waiting for Keith, I'm getting out of here right now. Shouldn't use the main door. It's not safe out there. The vents. I can hide in the vents. Come on. Come on. Something like this.
There you are. wonderful game. So you stand right there until I'm ready for you. Won't be long.
shit. Can't let them see me. I need to get back to my cell.
We'll be right back.
Where are you going? Where the hell have you been? I thought you'd forgotten about me. Sure, come on. Let's get the fuck out.
Cap, you're in no state to be doing anything like that. Go find somewhere to hide. I'll take care of this fucking psychopath.
Okay, just let me catch my breath. I'll find somewhere to lay low.
Still works.
Thank you.
Carl. Come on. Let's get out of here.
Roger that. Today is November 30th, 1997. Time, 13:25. I'm Detective Harry Johnson. With me is Detective Brian Davis. And sitting with us is Keith Williams. Okay, we'll start this interview by...
Listen, I've told you everything I know. I got a call from Tony informing me someone smashed the shop window. I left the house and got to the shop at around 10 p.m. Tony wasn't there. The shop was trashed. I saw the blood and guy's body at the back of the shop and called you guys. The last time. I don't know where Tony is.